Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject Fluid Mechanics and Machines. And this is lecture number 4.1, fourth chapter, first lecture. And we are going to discuss about the fundamentals of fluid flow. The topic for today's discussion, this lecture discussion, fundamentals of fluid flow, Lagrangian method, Eulerian method, types of fluid flow, flow pattern, steam line, steam tube, path line and streak line. The topic what we discussed earlier, so we discussed about the fluid properties, pressure and its measurements, fluid statics, and we solved a few problems on all the topics. The learning outcome for this lecture, so at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to explain the types of fluid flow, define streamline and steam tube, distinguish between streamline, path line and streak line. The study of fluid in motion involves consideration of kinematics and kinetics. In the earlier chapter, we studied about the fluid static, the fluid at rest, the properties of the fluid at rest, particularly we calculated pressure and center of pressure for different arrangements. And this topic, this lecture, where we are going to discuss the fluid in motion. So, the study of fluid in motion involves consideration of kinematics and kinetics. So, we define kinematics. The science deals with the geometry of motion of fluid without reference to the forces causing the motion is known as kinematics. So, we are going to deal the velocity. We are going to describe the velocity of the fluid flow without considering the force which causes the motion of the fluid, the force which causes the velocity, change of the velocity of the fluid. Kinematics involves merely the description of motion of the fluid in terms of space-time relationship. So, the time and the space, change of distance with respect to time, change of velocity with respect to time, everything we are going to define. And the science deals with the action of force in producing or changing the motion of the fluid is known as fluid kinetics. So, this is another topic, kinetics. So, the science deals with the force, action of forces in producing, changing the motion of the fluid is called as kinetics. And there are two methods to study the motion of fluid. One is Lagrangian method, another one is Eulerian method. So, what is Lagrangian method? A fluid particle is selected and the observation is made about the behavior of this particle during its course of motion through space and its velocity, acceleration, density, etc. are described. For example, the traffic police moving along the road and observing the traffic condition. That is what the example for Lagrangian method. So, you look at the diagram. So, there is an observer observing the motion of the fluid. The observer is moving along with the fluid particle. So, the observer is fixed with the missile. So, in the example, it is missile. But in fluid mechanics, the observer is moving along with the fluid particle and observing, recording the behavior of the fluid in terms of velocity, acceleration, density, etc. That is called as Lagrangian method. There is another method, Euler method, Eulerian method, where the observer is fixed at a particular position. So, like here, the observer is standing at a particular position and observing the fluid particle, the behavior of the fluid particle. So, any point in space occupied by the fluid is selected and the observation is made of whatever changes of velocity, density and pressure which takes place at that point. So, the observer is standing here at this location. What is the change in the pressure, velocity, density, everything? The observer is recording. That is what called as Eulerian method. So traffic police standing at one point and observing the traffic condition. That is what the Eulerian method. Now we are going to follow only the Eulerian method. So we measure the properties of the fluid at a particular location. So all the properties, whatever we discussed earlier, pressure, density, velocity, acceleration, everything we viscosity, everything we record by at a particular location. So we follow only the Eulerian method in all our discussions. The objective of the fluid mechanics is to determine velocity distribution of the fluid with respect to space coordinate and time. Once the velocity is known, then the pressure distribution force acting on the fluid can be determined. So it is not only for fluid mechanics, in fluid machines also where the fluid is flowing. Fluid machines like fluid pump, centrifugal pump, axial flow pump, hydraulic turbines and the open channel flow. So flow of water over river and the fluid is stored in a tank. So in all the cases, main objective of the fluid mechanics is to determine velocity and its distribution of the velocity. How the velocity is changing, how the velocity is, what is the velocity at different position, different points of the fluid flow. So that is what velocity distribution. So we have to determine velocity distribution in the flow field. Once you know the velocity distribution, then you can calculate the pressure distribution, force acting on the fluid, everything, any problem can be solved in fluid mechanics. So the objective is we have to determine velocity distribution in the fluid or fluid with respect to space coordinate x, y, z. In the case of a Cartesian system, the space coordinates are x, y, z, x direction, y direction and the z direction. The velocity is a distance travelled by the fluid particle at a particular time. The change in displacement, velocity equal to ds by dt. So this you have studied in engineering mechanics. So the change of distance with respect to time is called as velocity. So where dt is tends to 0. The velocity at any point depends on the space coordinate x, y, z and time t. So it is a vector quantity. It depends on the space and the time. So it has got the magnitude and the time. Velocity at any point can be resolved in three components u, v, w in x, y, z direction. So velocity is v, capital V normally. It denotes the velocity and the velocity has got three components u, v and w in the x direction, y direction, z direction. So the velocity in the x direction is u, velocity in the y direction is v and velocity in the z direction is w. So u equal to dx by dt. So change in the position, change in the distance in the x direction with respect to time. V equal to dy by dt, change in the distance in the y direction with respect to time. W equal to dz by dt, change in the distance in the z direction with respect to time. That is what the u, v, w and this you have to remember. So this u, v, definition of u, v, w, it is very important in all our discussion in fluid kinematics. And we classify the fluid flow. So there are different methodology of classifying the fluid flow. So the first classification, we classify the steady flow or unsteady flow. So, the steady flow may be defined as the flow in which the fluid properties, velocity, pressure, density, etc. are constant with respect to time. So, there is no change in the property with respect to time. So, velocity, the major properties are velocity, pressure and density. So, mathematically, dou V by dou T equal to 0, dou P by dou T equal to 0 and dou rho by dou T equal to 0. There is no change in the property with respect to time. So, look at the diagram. To understand the steady flow, look at the diagram. So, this is the flow velocity or flow parameter at a time t equal to maybe 0 seconds at the start. So, this is the velocity or the property at the t equal to 1 second. After 1 second, we observe. So, look at the parameter. The parameters are identical. Length of the arrowhead is the same. So, there is no change in the property with respect to time. That is what the steady flow. And the fluid is said to be unsteady flow if the fluid properties are changes with respect to time. So, dou V by dou T is not equal to 0. They are changing with the time. Dou P by dou T is not equal to 0 and dou rho by dou T is not equal to 0. They are changing with respect to time. Now look at this image, this diagram. So this is the time t equal to 0 second, and this is t time after some time, t equal to 1 second or 2 second or 1 minute even. So after some time, there is change in the property. So length of the aqueduct is changing. So this is what called as unsteady flow. So practically, all the flow, they are unsteady flow. Majority of the flow, look at the, you observe, just observe the flow of water in a open river. So it is unsteady flow. So the properties are changing with respect to time. And uniform flow, non-uniform flow. When the velocity of the fluid velocity of flow of the fluid does not change both in magnitude and direction from point to point in the flow field at a given instant of time is called as uniform flow. So for uniform flow, there is no change in the velocity with respect to position. So the change in velocity with respect to position is equal to zero. For example, flow of liquids under pressure through a long pipeline of constant diameter is uniform flow. So look at here. So this image. So left side is uniform flow, the flow direction. So the same, there is no change in the velocity with respect to position. So everywhere the velocity is the same. Everywhere the velocity is the same. There is no change in the velocity with respect to position. But look at here. So the velocities are changing because of the flow vorticity. This is non-uniform flow. So look at in the diagram. So the upper layer of the fluids, down second layer of the fluid, both are moving with the same velocity. This is uniform flow. There is no change in the velocity with respect to position. But look at the second diagram. The upper layer is moving with a higher velocity. Lower layer is moving with a slower velocity. This is non-uniform flow. The lower layer, the velocity changing with respect to position. Y direction, the velocity is changing. Then when the velocity of the fluid flow changes both in magnitude and direction from point to point in the flowing fluid at any given instant of time is called as non-uniform flow. So for non-uniform flow, dou V by dou S not equal to zero. For example, the flow of liquid under pressure through a long pipeline of varying diameter is non-uniform flow. So when the diameter is changing, varying, increasing or decreasing, then it is called as non-uniform. Laminar flow and turbulent flow. This is another classification. Laminar flow and turbulent flow. The flow is said to be laminar when the fluid particles moves in a layer with one layer of the fluid sliding smoothly over the adjacent layer. So the flow of viscous fluid is generally treated as laminar. What is viscous fluid? Flow of oil. Oil is viscous, high viscous fluid. So that is stated as laminar flow. So this is what the laminar flow. The fluid particle we consider, each fluid particle, they are moving in a straight line. This is laminar flow. When the fluid particles are moving in a haphazard or disorderly manner, then the flow is said to be turbulent flow. For example, the flow of liquid in a channel, water supply in a pipeline are examples of turbulent flow. Look at the fluid particle, movement of the fluid particle. They are frequently changing the direction. All the practical flow, they are turbulent. Remember, all the practical flow, they are turbulent. So it is very difficult to establish laminar flow in the practical situation. Then compressible, incompressible flow. For compressible flow, the density of the fluid changes from point to point in the flow field. So for compressible, so it is compressible. So rho is not constant, density is not constant. For example, flow of air or gas. For incompressible flow, the density of the fluid does not change from point to point in the flow field. So for compressible flow, density is changing. For incompressible flow, density is not changing, that is, density is constant. For incompressible flow, rho is constant. For example, flow of water, mercury or any liquid. So flow of any liquid is incompressible flow. Flow of any gas or vapor, it is compressible flow. So in this subject, we are going to deal with incompressible flow. We are going to deal with the flow of water. Majority of the cases we are going to deal with flow of water. It is incompressible flow. In thermal engineering, we deal with the air compressor, we deal with the flow of refrigerant. So those are examples for the compressible fluid flow. Gas dynamics, so it is a compressible flow. So we are going to deal in this subject only the incompressible flow. and this is the example. So this is compressible flow, diagram of the compressible flow, and this is incompressible flow. So here the fluid, the velocity volume is the same for any pressure, whatever the pressure we apply. But here by changing the pressure, the volume is changing. So this is compressible and this is incompressible. And rotational irrotational flow. A flow is said to be rotational if the fluid particles while moving in the direction of flow rotates about their mass and about its own center. When it is rotating, fluid particles are rotating, that is rotational flow. The flow is said to be irrotational if the fluid particles while moving in the direction of the flow do not rotate about the mass center. So this is irrotational and this is rotational. Look at the particles. So these are all fluid particles. So it is moving in a curved path. Here again it is moving in a curved path. The fluid particle enters here, there is no change in the position. It is moving as it is from left to right. But here about the center, it is changing its position. This is rotational and this is irrotational flow. And 1, 2, and 3 dimensional flow. So 1-dimensional flow, 2-dimensional flow, 3-dimensional flow. So 1-dimensional flow, the flow properties, fluid properties are changing with respect to one space coordinate. 2-dimensional flow, they are changing with respect to 2 space coordinates. 3-dimensional flow, the fluid properties are changing with respect to 3 coordinates. So all the practical flow, once again remember, it is a 3-dimensional flow. But for theoretical simplification, we assume 1-dimensional flow or 2-dimensional flow and we do all mathematical calculations. Right? So this is example for 1-dimensional flow, 2-dimensional flow and 3-dimensional flow. So what is the difference? For 3-dimensional flow, velocity is the function of x, y, z. 3-dimensional unsteady flow, velocity is the function of x, y, z and t. For steady flow, velocity is the function of x, y, z. For 2-dimensional flow, velocity is a function of x, y and t. For steady flow, velocity is a function of x and y. For 1-dimensional unsteady flow, velocity is a function of x and t. There is only one direction and time parameter. Steady flow, velocity is a function of x only. This is the most simplified situation. 1-dimensional steady flow. So, normally we deal with 1-dimensional steady flow or 1-dimensional unsteady flow for theoretical, all theoretical calculations. So these are all different types of fluid flow. Just a recall, flow with the steady flow, unsteady flow, uniform flow, non-uniform flow, compressible flow, incompressible flow, uniform, non-uniform flow, then compressible, incompressible flow, laminar turbulent flow, rotational, irrotational flow, 1-dimensional, 2-dimensional, 3-dimensional flow. So these are all the different types of flow which you have to remember. But we will discuss one by one, we slowly discuss. Then flow pattern. So streamline, we define streamline. Streamline is an imaginary curve drawn through the flowing fluid in such a way that the tangent to it at any given point at any point gives the direction of the velocity of the flow at a point. The equation of the streamline, look at this. This is the streamline, explanation for the streamline. These are all the trace of the fluid particle, the path of the fluid particle, the curved line, right, with the arrowhead. The streamline is an imaginary curve drawn through the flowing fluid in such a way that the tangent to it at any point gives the direction of the velocity of the flow in that point. So we draw a tangent, V. We draw a tangent. So V is the velocity. So it is resolved for two directions. It is a two-dimensional plane. So U and V. So velocity in the X direction is U, velocity in the Y direction is V. So for a particular fluid particle here, we define the velocity. So the equation of streamline in three-dimensional flow is given by dx by u equal to dy by v equal to dz by w. So this equation you have to remember, the velocity equation for streamline in a three-dimensional coordinate. So normally there will be problem asked with reference to this equation. So you have to remember this equation, dx by u equal to dy by v equal to dz by w. For this is the equation for streamline in three-dimensional flow. So there are certain characteristics of the streamline. A streamline cannot intersect itself. No two streamlines can cross. So every streamline will have its own path. It will flow in a different path. Fluid particle do not cross the streamline. So look at here. So here one particle is moving in the same line, in this line. Another particle is moving. Another particle, it is moving in the particular line. So the fluid particle do not cross the streamline. The series of streamlines indicate the flow pattern at that instant. So this is the line that indicates the flow pattern. And streamline spacing varies inversely as the velocity. Converging of streamline and a particular direction shows the accelerator flow. When the lines are converging, that is called as accelerator flow. And when the lines are diverging, that is called as decelerated flow. That we have to understand. So still there are four characteristics of the streamline. And steam tube. So this is what the example for the steam tube. A steam tube is a fluid mass bounded by a group of streamlines. So look at here. These are all streamlines. The continuous line, dotted lines on the back side, they are streamlines. So the steam tubes is a fluid mass bounded by a group of streamlines. So the fluid flowing inside covering all the line, that is called as fluid bounded by the group of streamlines. Example, flow through the pipe, flow through the nozzle or the diffuser. This is what the steam tube. There are the examples for the steam tube. Again, the steam tube has a finite dimension. So what is dimension? The length, diameter at the inlet, diameter at the outlet, they are the dimensions. So steam tube has a finite dimension. There is no flow across the bounding surface of the steam tube. So as we defined earlier, the fluid particles, they are not crossing the streamline. So here again, the fluid particles are not crossing the streamlines in the steam tube. The shape of the steam tube changes from one instant to another because of change in the position of the streamline. So the shape of the steam tube is also changing because of the change in the position of the streamline. And the path line. So next definition is path line. The path followed by the fluid particle in motion over the period of time. That is what the path line. For steady flow, the streamline and the path line, they are identical. For unsteady flow, the path line and the streamline, they are different in the flow field. So here the dotted line is the path line. So this is some dye is injected from here. So the dotted line 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, up to 10, the line is called as path line. Similarly, there are different lines, they are called as path lines. Another one definition is streak line. The streak line may be defined as the line that is traced by the fluid particle by passing through a fixed point in the flow field. For steady flow conditions, streak line, path line, streamlines are identical. So look at here, streak line, continuous line. So the continuous line connecting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that is called as streak line, the trace of the line. So the streak line is maybe defined as the line that is traced by the fluid particle passing through a fixed point in the flow field. So this is particle number 2, we consider particle number 2, the fluid particle at a particular location, the trace of the fluid particle is called as streak line. So streamline, path line, streak line. So for steady flow conditions, all the three lines are identical. For unsteady flow conditions, all the three lines are different. Steam tube, the fluid mass bounded by the steam lines is called a steam tube. So all these things are very fundamental of the fluid flow that you ought to understand. In future, we will be solving the problem using the equation what we given here in the streamline, du by x, dx by u plus dv by dy by v equal to dw, dz by w. That equation you have to remember. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I published. Design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, fluid mechanics, gas dynamics, jet propulsion, thermal engineering, and fluid mechanics and machinery. So this book will be useful for you in this subject. You can refer to it for more information and additional problems. And also I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures on the subject. You can refer to it for your better learning and for passing the GATE examination. So thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the comments box. So you subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated videos, and you can write to my mail ID for any clarification on the subject. I will sincerely answer. We'll meet again in another video in the fluid kinematics. We continue the lecture in the next lecture.